Incremental ratings. You may think that's a blank collection. Wrong. Spoiler alert, look at the name, Ghost. If I go to the stats and I click all history, I will get what's called the Ghost reviews. And look at that, 6.6 million reviews. This video is not to flex, but the opposite. This is very shameful from my part. I'm making this video to prove a point so you don't repeat the same mistakes I did. I did it the hard way. Because back then, I was an early adopter, were almost no videos on YouTube about Anki and stuff like that. And do you see here? 2023, yeah, missing days, 22, and the further I go, the most days are active. But hey, that's the catch. That's not what they have done. This is what they have done and deleted. Yeah. So I have done this graph. I have two profiles on this dummy ghost that I have. So basically, the 6.6 million reviews from flashcards that I no longer keep represents 93% of the collection. Everything I did in my life. So imagine that. In more than 15 years, all of the time that I used Anki, I was nodding off during night, and I was pushing myself when I didn't want that because I used it as a cramming tool for some years in the beginning. Not anymore, but at the beginning. All of this, I am telling you that 93%, it's evaporated, gone, useless, crap, nothing I can use. And I only keep about 5% for my main profile and 100,000 for my phone profile. But if we go to repetition time, it's more or less the same. I keep more on the main profile in Japanese because I take longer, more seconds to answer. That's it. But the number you see here are the number of hours. I have wasted more than 3,300 hours. This is just the review time. You have to add the creation time. Yes, at the beginning I use shared text, or I use my knowledge in programming to generate flashcards as well. But I have manually created, even if they were crap, very low quality, low effort, more than 100,000 flashcards for exams. Because I did another mistake I did, is that I not just graduated from the university, I did an undergraduate, a bachelor degree, another bachelor degree, a master degree, a second master degree, and a third master degree. And I even started the PhD, which I moved on. So basically, I had a lot of opportunities to use Anki for cramming, because I had a lot of exams to do in my life, something I profoundly regret. But that's not the point of this video. Just to let you know that why I have deleted so much stuff, because it was not applicable, so I just did the exam, passed the exam, and when I have the grade on paper, then I delete the deck. What I did is that I exported the deck as a file, just in case, to share it with someone else or whatever may happen, and gone forever. And I did this year on years at the beginning. And later on, I was first mixing and then only doing what I wanted in Anki. I no longer had exams, but I was using it very badly. And I learned hundreds or tens of thousands of vocabulary in foreign languages, very obscure, that I never, in 10 years, because I have been using Anki for that while, then it's, wait. All of the flashcards I created like a decade ago are worthless. I haven't seen this elsewhere. I couldn't apply this knowledge in real life. I memorized all of that. For what? Yeah, good to know. It's this obscure fact, and that's it. It's not applicable. Don't do this. If you're in the school system, you are in the medical school or whatever, you will need to use Anki as a cramming tool. It is what it is. But at least you will do like the smart cramming. So you will do the least amount of repetitions possible. Just the opposite of me. this number is not good. You may think the most reviews possible, the highest, the better, means more knowledge. The opposite is true. Means that you are wasting a lot of time to acquire that knowledge. So what you should aim for is to have the minimum reviews possible with the maximum knowledge that is applicable. First, you want to remember being able to recall that fact, that knowledge. Second, to apply that in real life. And third, to be as cheap as possible, so the least number of reviews as possible by average. That is the definition of success. And what I'm showing to you in this collection, it's the opposite. Don't follow my case. Usually, I'm not no one special. I started like clueless, not knowing what a flashcard is or what space operation is. I had even broken English. I couldn't even read the documentation in English back then. So imagine that. My advantage over most people who will watch this video, I hope, is that I have been here for a long period of time, almost 16 years. I had time to do a lot of mistakes. That's it. That's my, let's say, superpower. I invested thousands of hours doing a lot of mistakes. So please, don't repeat and don't waste the time I did. If you see, you start noticing a pattern that what you have in Anki is not applicable in real life, think twice. Should I put it, should I keep it in Anki or not? And from now on, ask yourself, hey, will be this applicable? So like, what is the threshold? Not because it's already done and I can do it. Or I use AI and poof, have many flashcards at once. Means I have to do it. That has been a trap of mine. Or just because I see results that, hey, I can memorize a lot of things and in a split second I can tell you every detail in the muscle, in anatomy and so on, and the bones. Yeah, I had the honeymoon period, but I use it in a very bad way. And then, after many years, look at this. That's a testimony of almost every single day I wasted my time. Don't do this. That's my message. Please let me know your opinion in case I need further examples with real flashcards I had. I will need to recover from backups from many years ago. But I will do it if you request it. But for now, that's enough. See you incrementally.